Families of two missing activists in the Philippines secure a protective writ from the Supreme Court for their relatives. The High Court issued the writ of amparo on Tuesday for Elizabeth Magbanwa and Alipo Wat, who were allegedly abducted by state forces. The two are members of the Pilisang Mayo Uno and were known to have last attended a meeting of the labor group in May. The petition was filed by their relatives before the court this month, naming top military and security officials as respondents. They urged the court to allow an inspection of the military's headquarters in Quezon City and of the Fort Magsaysay in Nueva Ecija Province in the hopes of finding the two. The tribunal also directed the Court of Appeals to conduct a hearing and resolve the case. The writ covers cases of extrajudicial killings and enforced disappearances. It seeks to protect individuals when their life and security are deemed under threat of state forces.
The Philippines vows to intensify its crackdown on online child sexual exploitation. That's after a seven-year study by the UK-based International Justice Mission showed the Philippines is now the world's largest known source of child pornography. Philippine Justice Secretary Boying Remulla says incidents of online child exploitation have been reported across all regions in the country. The Philippine Special Envoy to the United Nations, Nikki Teodoro, believes access to technology and pandemic lockdowns fueled the rise of abuse.
My job is to report in the UN anong nangyayari sa bansa natin. So now I will be going there in September to announce that we're number one for child trafficking, online pornography. I'm very embarrassed. It's a billion-dollar industry.
Philippine Interior Secretary Benhur Abalo says the Philippines has conducted over 200 operations against online child sexual exploitation since 2017. This led to the filing of 198 cases.
Philippine senators opened their probe into a controversial sugar importation order that's been deemed illegal by Malacanang. Executive Secretary Vic Rodriguez faced senators asserting President Marcos had nothing to do with Sugar Order Number 4, which seeks to import 300,000 metric tons of sugar. But Senator Risa Hontiveros wants him to return to clarify his own role in the controversy.
Sinasabi ng Malacanang na illegal ang SO4. How can it be illegal when it was the Executive Secretary himself who issued a memorandum dated 15th July 2022 authorizing former Yusek Sebastian to sit as ex-officio chairman sa nasabing memo, he has the authority to sign administrative issuances.
Meanwhile, one group claims they were duped by the Sugar Regulatory Administration into signing the controversial order.
We were made to believe po that the president ordered the importation of 300, they wanted the importation of 300,000 metric tons because it was a national emergency. So we signed because who are we to question the wisdom of the president? Si Mr. Serapica, wakwak na wala na daw asukal, wala naman siya nagpa-survey. Ilang beses na po, I wrote him 4 or 5 times, you make a national survey. That is the job of the SRA.
Malacanang mom on calls for President Marcos to appoint an agriculture secretary. This comes amid suggestions Marcos, who is concurrent agriculture chief, should pick a full-time secretary if government wants to curtail the alleged cartel behind the sugar crunch in the country. Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles also says Malacanang will not comment on testimonies on the congressional probe into the sugar import mess. Angeles notes they will wait for Congress to complete its investigation. She adds customs agents will continue inspecting sugar warehouses nationwide to check on possible sugar hoarding or smuggling.